Right now at 5, there will be more than 1.7 million cases of cancer diagnosed in the U.S. this year. But a shocking number of those cases are actually misdiagnosed.
CBS 2's Dr. Max Gomez here to tell us about new high-tech tools that are hoped to lead to the right diagnosis and treatment, doctor.
Yeah, that's right, guys. You know, many people think that it's pretty obvious when a biopsy is cancer. But cells don't have little signs on them that say cancer. It takes an experienced pathologist to tell if a cell is cancerous and what kind of cancer it is. That can make the difference between life and death.
When Mike Minshall was told the tumor he had developed had been repeatedly misdiagnosed as benign and that it was actually melanoma, it was devastating. He was told he had just 2 months to live.
The tears well up in your eyes.
Turns out cancer misdiagnoses are not uncommon. Some studies find that as many as a third are incorrect, calling some tumors benign when they're malignant and the other way around, subjecting patients to unnecessary treatment. But the large majority of errors was in misclassifying the type of cancer. But thanks to new technology, Mike was able to get the correct diagnosis and was started on a treatment that now has him cancer-free.
It has revolutionized cancer diagnostics, and this technology gives me the tools to answer the question, which I couldn't, you know, do that 5 years ago.
The expert's second opinion from the Ohio State University Comprehensive Cancer Center, James Cancer Hospital, and Solove Research Institute was enabled by digital pathology, a huge improvement over the decades-old technique of placing tumor cells on glass slides for examination under a microscope. Getting them processed and mailed for review by specialists could take days, even weeks.
With digital pathology, you take those same glass slides and you digitize them and create millions of pixels, converting them into a large image.
The digital images are far easier to store, share, and access, and a diagnosis can be done in hours by pathologists specializing in that particular cancer, who can more accurately stage and grade specific types of malignancy.
Thank God my son and daughter-in-law were pushing me to go and get this other opinion.
Now, even though this kind of telemedicine can bring expert diagnosis to even the most remote areas, the more important message here is that if there is any question about whether you have cancer or about its type or stage, get a second opinion. Again, it could save your life.
You bet. Thank you, doctor. You bet.